Hey, what's going on? I'm Allie, and if you're new to this channel, we release weekly filmmaking and video editing tutorials, so if you want to learn more about either, consider subscribing. Will and I have filmed a lot of corporate videos over the years. Beforehand, I'm very diligent about sending out a PDF of what not to wear, specifically indicating that you should not wear fine lines or fine patterns because that will create the moiré effect. I also ask clients to bring a few different options so we can see what will look good on camera. Sometimes they do, sometimes we show up on the day and they have one shirt or one jacket, and of course it has those fine little details that creates exactly what we're trying to avoid. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to reduce or remove, depending on your footage, the moiré effect, those wavy lines that you just don't wanna see on your clients or on your own clothes. Okay, so we're in Premiere Pro with a clip that's suffering from some major moiré issues that we're gonna reduce in just a second. First, it's useful to know that when you're editing, depending on the size you've set the frame in your program monitor or the size of your computer monitor, the moiré in footage may show up more or less. So it's important to review your final exported file at different screen sizes if you suspect more moiré might show up. This is because different frame sizes will cause the very thin patterns on the shirt to move closer together or farther apart, as the pixels in the footage will have more or less compression. Moiré typically happens when the camera has sharp focus on tiny thin patterns where there's a repeating pattern of a thin opaque line followed by a transparent gap. Okay, so let's go to our effect window and type in Gaussian blur. There it is in the video effects blur and sharpen folder. We'll drag that onto our clip and go to effect controls where we can adjust this effect. Let's try bringing it to 8. Depending on your clip, you may need to increase or decrease the amount of Gaussian blur. Okay, and that creates a subtle blur over the entire clip and we can no longer see moiré. I'll turn the effect off for a second. And yep, that's definitely made a difference. Turn it back on. Next, under the effect, we can click on this pen tool so that we can create a mask around just the clothing. So just the shirt will be affected by this blur effect rather than the entire clip. Now let's bring our cursor to the very beginning of the clip so that we're creating our mask over the first frame. I'm gonna track this mask to follow the movement of the shirt as the clip plays through, and I want to extend the mask a little bit beyond the frame just to ensure that it does still cover the shirt as it tracks with the movement. Let's zoom out of this clip on the program monitor by clicking this drop-down menu and choosing 25% so that we can extend our mask beyond the frame itself in case we need to make any adjustments to the mask later. So I'll draw a mask around the shirt. If you needed to adjust the mask at all, you could grab any of these points and move them accordingly. Now under the effect where the mask is, let's click on the toggle to place our first keyframe to hold the position of this mask, and press this play button to track the position of the mask as the shirt moves throughout the clip. This will take a few moments, and when it's complete, with every frame of this clip, a keyframe has been created to hold the position of the mask as it moves over each frame. Awesome. We'll go back to fit view, and as I scrub over this clip, you can see that using Premiere's tracking has done a pretty great job of following the shirt. And there you go. That's how to reduce the moiré effect in Premiere Pro. Thanks for checking this tutorial out. If you found it helpful, let us know in the comments below. And to see more video tutorials about filmmaking and editing, subscribe to our channel because we release tutorials weekly. Thanks, and we'll see you in another video.